So your PC keeps on restarting and you're looking for a fix. If you're currently experiencing this one, let me show you some basic solutions. Everything you need to know, coming up. There are several reasons that why your PC keeps on restarting after pressing the power button. Over time, your PC will be dusty and that's inevitable. And yes, this is one of the reasons that why your PC keeps on restarting. You might ask why. Well, dust causes PC components not to detect each other. A simple but quick solution is to clean it off, especially on the RAM sticks. Before removing the RAM sticks to clean it, make sure that you turn off your PC, unplug it from the wall outlet, and make sure that there are no power left. To do that, press the power button while your PC is unplugged. Also, wear an anti-static band if you have one. If you don't, then rub your hands on a metal surface to remove those statics on your hands before touching any of your PC components. You might ask again why? Well, static hands can destroy your PC components, so be very careful. After cleaning it off, then just try powering your PC back on. If it works, then you're good to go. If it doesn't, do me a favor by checking your PC components if they are plugged in all the way. Make sure that the 12-pin and the 6-pin on your power supply are connected all the way in your motherboard, GPU, SSD, or hard drive if you got one. After checking the power supply connections, make sure that the RAM sticks on your boot drive are plugged in correctly all the way. I know these are basic things, but we need to do this first before we go for deeper solutions. Anyway, try powering your PC back on. So if those basic solutions doesn't still work for you, let's go a little deeper. Over time, or at least after a year, your RAM sticks will eventually have these dark residues on the circuit connectors. These dark residues causes a fluctuating detection. What I mean by that is, sometimes the motherboard detects the RAM sticks and sometimes it doesn't. Or it could be both when you try to turn on your PC. When the fluctuating detection happens, then your PC will keep on restarting by itself. So the solution for this one is to clean it off. To do that, grab an eraser like this one and erase those dark residues on the RAM stick's circuit connectors. Make sure that there are no eraser dirt left before placing it back on your motherboard. And again, try powering your PC back on. Now the next solution depends on where you are at before the continuous restarting happens. So pause the video, check out the timestamp, and skip to wherever you need to. BIOS issue. This happens when you try to overclock your PC and mess it up. Yes, messing up the BIOS may trigger this automatic restarting issue. The solution for this is to reset your BIOS by removing the CMOS battery. To do that, remove the CMOS battery for 5 to 10 minutes and return it back again. Now, try to power your PC back on and check if it works. Overheating. When your PC and your GPU reach its max temperature, your PC will automatically restart. If your PC is still detecting the temperature level, it will keep on restarting itself. If this happens to you, I suggest you let your PC cool down a little bit before powering your PC back on. Also, during your gaming sessions, watch out for your temperature. I suggest you use MSI Afterburner to monitor your GPU and CPU temperature. You might have upgraded at some point or did a thorough cleaning and tore your PC apart. If you have done this, then you might have messed up the system panel connectors. Now go to your motherboard's manual and make sure that those system panel connectors are plugged in the right way. Messing this up will not blow your PC up, but it will be troublesome if you didn't plug the connectors correctly. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, but if the solution doesn't still work for you, then you might be facing a hardware failure that causes your computer to reboot automatically. The problem could be your RAM, boot drive, power supply, graphics card, or motherboard, one of which might be faulty component. If you want to know which is the one and you got more patience in troubleshooting your PC, I suggest continue watching. Otherwise, I need you to stop from here. Anyway, let's try your RAM sticks first. If you got two RAM sticks, try each one at a time and start your PC. Normally, by the time you're making this video, PCs will boot correctly even if you got one 4GB RAM sticks plugged in your motherboard. If you tried each one at a time and still doesn't work, then try using the other RAM slots on your motherboard. If it works, then the other RAM slots are broken. If it doesn't, let's just continue to troubleshoot the other PC parts. Now let's try checking out your boot drive. If you got a spare hard drive or SSD, try replacing it with your old boot drive. Now I want you to go to the BIOS and set it as the first boot device. Start your PC, and if your PC is stopped restarting and you see this on your screen, then your boot drive is broken. But if the restarting still persists, let's continue to troubleshoot the other PC parts. Now let's check out your graphics card. This next step will work on Intel with HD graphics and Ryzen CPUs with Vega graphics. If yours doesn't have this onboard graphics support, please don't try this out. Moving on, remove your graphics card from your motherboard and try plugging your monitor using the DVI, HDMI, or DisplayPort on your motherboard's I/O. If you got a display and it's not restarting anymore, then you got yourself a broken GPU. If the restarting issue still persists, then it's not your GPU. Just place it back again. If you have tried all the troubleshooting I suggested and the continuous restarting still persists, then your PSU might have a low power draw. And of course, low power draw causes continuous restarting. Not unless you're a technician, there's no way you could fix your own power supply. And right now, the only solution for that is to get a new one. This time, please don't cheap out and buy an 80 plus bronze at least. Well, I've listed a Trustworthy power supply in the link in the description. Make sure you check that out. Every suggestion I have in this video are in accordance to my experience over the years building and troubleshooting PCs. If you found this video helpful in any way, give us a thumbs up and let us know in the comment section below. Also, share to us your experience and other solution if you have one. So that's it guys, thanks for watching and we'll see you in the next one.